Hey, what's up, everybody? Dornell Dana coming at you with another kick-ass episode of the Art of Mortgage Marketing podcast. And today we're going to be talking about why your company will never solve your marketing problems. Why, even though they want to, even though they have your best interest in mind, even though they see the greatness in you, even though they're willing to spend time, energy, and money to support you, they will never be able to get to the root cause of what's causing you to struggle in your mortgage business as it relates to your marketing. Now, I'm not trying to be cynical. I'm not trying to rain on your parade. I'm not trying to create a divisive relationship between you and your broker owner or your supervisor or your manager. I'm just speaking truth. I'm going to be dropping some truth bombs today that you guys need to hear. You may not want to hear it, but you need to hear it. And again, this has nothing to do with ill intention. This has everything to do with the fact that they're just unequipped and ill-equipped to be able to get to the real root of the problem when it comes to what's hindering you and what's stopping you from stepping into greatness in your mortgage business when it comes to your marketing. So that being said, let's jump into it and do it, shall we? Let's start off with the first reason why your company will never be able to solve your marketing problems. And frankly, this was spawned out of me having a conversation very recently with two people that were rolling the dice on their career, basically committing career suicide at the very worst and causing them to put the brakes on their growth at the very least when it comes to them having delusional optimism around empowering their marketing department at their company and relying on them to help them take their business to the next level. There's nothing wrong with using them for what they're good for. There's nothing wrong with squeezing as much profit-producing nectar out of that fruit as you can. I'm all for that. But they were struggling in their business. They're looking at their February and January pipelines. They're anemic. They're very slow. It's like crickets waiting for the phone to ring. They don't have a proactive plan. They don't have a formula for success. They're doing the same old thing, getting the same old results. And then they step into this delusional optimism, thinking that their broker owner or their manager or their marketing department is going to solve the problem. I got news for you. It ain't going to solve the problem. And it breaks my heart because these people have good intentions. They got a ton of talent, acumen, expertise, and experience. And yet they're basically being held hostage to delusional optimism because they think their company, who is obviously wanting them to win, is going to solve that for them. And it just ain't going to happen. I've been in this game 16 years, haven't seen it happen once. Chances are you'll be no exception. And the reason for that is as follows. The first reason is they can't give you that which they don't have. They can't give you what they don't have. They don't have the insight, the skill, the knowledge, the expertise, the specialization to be able to give you the secret sauce. They work in generalizations because they're dumbing it all down to either A, what worked for them years ago, or B, what has passed through compliance, which is all castrated. As soon as you run it through compliance, everything's castrated because it's dumbed down to, like, you know, the lowest common denominator. It's super snoring boring. And we're going to get into that more in a moment. And or C rather, it's just simply too normal, too average, too generic, too general. And we're going to get into more details on why that doesn't work in a moment. But you got to be knowing, if you want to be a champion in this business, if you want to be extraordinary in this business, you got to be zigging while everyone else is zagging. You want to be a champion in this business, you can't afford to have chump level marketing that's just ordinary and average, because that ain't going to take you where you want to be. So it's not that they don't want to help you create a breakthrough. It's that they're unequipped and ill-equipped to help you because they're relying on stuff that frankly didn't work, doesn't work nowadays because it's old hat, outdated, or it's just dumbed down to the lowest common denominator because it's been filtered to compliance and because it's for a mass audience of loan officers for the entire team. And it's just too generic. It's too whitewashed. It's too vanilla. It's too ordinary. And so that's one of the reasons why relying on your company to help you create a breakthrough is going to fall short 99.9% of the time. And chances are you are not going to be that rare exception. The second reason why marketing departments and your company in general is not going to help you create a breakthrough is because conventional thinking creates conventional results. We talked about that before. We'll talk about it again. If you do ordinary things and you come from ordinary premises and you come from an ordinary approach, you're going to get ordinary results. Any extraordinary achievement, any extraordinary breakthrough is going to come as a result of extraordinary thinking, extraordinary approaches that are out of the ordinary. That's why we call them extraordinary. They're outside of the herd mentality. They're outside of the follow the herd, me too mentality. It's like the average Joe LO follows the herd, right? Everyone else is chasing realtors, me too. Everyone has great rates, me too. Everyone has great service, me too. It's a me too mentality that has you following the herd, doing conventional things with a conventional approach, with a conventional mindset, with conventional premises and presuppositions that get you conventional results. If you want to create an avalanche of awesome in your business, it's not going to come from being conventional. It's going to come from you being out of the ordinary, zigging while others are zagging, and standing up from the clutter and standing up from the pack. So for you to be that, you have to step out of the norm. The problem with your marketing department, your manager, and so on is they're trained to think based on the norm because everything has to be dumbed down for compliance. Everything has to be fitting into a box of what's approved and what's allowed. Everything has to be, you know, based on their past experience, which, like I said before, is usually completely outdated. What worked for them 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15 years ago just ain't working anymore. It's a changed world. It's an evolved economy. It's a changed mindset. It's a changed demographic, psychographic profile in your market, both for clients, prospects, and for realtor partners. And so we got to evolve. We got to keep up. But if you're living in the past and you're trying to apply that to the now, chances are you're going to get a point of diminishing returns that has you spinning your wheels, banging your head against the wall, showing up to the gunfight with a butter knife, and you'll be unequipped and ill-equipped to win on the front lines of capitalism in the real world. So we got to keep you front and center. We got to get you cutting edge, not bleeding edge or trailing edge. And in order for you to do that, you got to stay with the times. You got to keep up with the times. And that's not an easy feat when you're learning all the compliance measures, you're learning all the requirements and regulations, you're learning about all the programs and products, you're learning about how to find a home for the loan and which lender does that and which lender does this. And I mean, there's a lot of minutia to keep up with. And now you got to figure out how to become a marketing expert too. You kidding me? It's a lot, right? Plus, on top of that, it's not just your marketing. It's learning how to get the most from yourself, getting the right psychology. We saw recently Conor McGregor knock out Cowboy in like 40 seconds. He just absolutely obliterated him. He was like a hot knife through freaking butter. And he knocked him out within 40 seconds. I knew he was going to dominate, but I didn't realize he was going to dominate that much. One of his secret weapons most people overlook is his mindset training. He invests hundreds of thousands of dollars in elite level mindset training with experts, world-class experts like Tony Robbins. One of the things that separates McGregor from all the other mediocre majority in the combat sports world is he takes his mindset exceedingly seriously. And he spends more time on developing his mindset and his confidence and his certainty than he does in his tactical and strategic and physical training. And that's what makes him so powerful and so effective. Because when he shows up, he is owning and capturing and leveraging his full power. He's tapping his full potential. Most mortgage companies, as much as they do their best, they just don't have the specialized knowledge and skill on how to help you do that. Chances are they're not even doing it themselves. How can they give you that which they don't have? They can't. So that's another reason why they're not going to be able to help you create a breakthrough. The other thing that usually is a big reason why your company will not help you create a breakthrough at the level you need or want is because what worked 10 to 20 years ago ain't working nowadays. Things have changed. Approaches with realtors that worked 5, 10, 15 years ago, 20 years ago, doesn't work anymore. Approaches with reaching out to clients through your database or reaching out by social media, stuff that worked even 3, 5 years ago, doesn't work anymore. We got to continually evolve and have new iterations and keep shifting our approach and pivoting so that you can get more and more results and keep up with what's working. And in order to do that, you really have to have specialized knowledge. So that's another key thing is if you're listening to your manager, like I was talking with a lady today and she's like, yeah, my manager is going to be helping me book appointments with real estate agents and so on and so forth. And he's going to help me do that. I'm thinking, oh no, the beginning of the end, because that manager, even though they have their best intentions and want to serve this loan officer to their breakthrough, they're relying on their past experience. And usually these managers have been in the game for 5, 10, 15 years. So they're going to get them to do old conventional methods that get old conventional results called cold calling, chasing, begging, bribing. And that stuff just doesn't work nowadays. It just doesn't. These realtors, their eyeballs roll in the back of their head. It's snoozeville. It's dullsville. It's boring. And unless you want, and unless these realtors are complaining about insomnia, I wouldn't suggest you using those snoozeville, snoring, boring methods, because if you do, it's going to get them to slip into a coma. They're not going to give you the time of day. They're going to reject you, and it's not going to go so well for you. It's like heading to the gunfight with a butter knife, heading east looking for the sunset. It ain't going to go so well, even if you're motivated, even if you're defiantly resolved, even if you're fired up, bright-eyed, and bushy-tailed. If you're heading east looking for the sunset, we got a freaking problem, because your approach ain't going to work. So old methods that are old hat, chances are going to get same old results that are going to be lackluster, insufficient, inadequate. The next reason why your company, chances are, will not be able to help you create a breakthrough as much as they would love to and as much as you'd love them to do so is because cookie cutter crap methods produce cookie cutter crap results, crappy results. For example, if you're relying on them to help you book appointments with realtors, chances are it ain't going to go so well. If you're relying on them to help you manage your database, I had someone the other day, he signed an agreement with his shop, with his company, that basically said he does not have access to his database. By the way, never sign an agreement like that. That is career suicide, because the single most valuable asset in your business is your database. And if you're signing that away, you don't have a business. You have a glorified job trading time for money on the time for money treadmill. And you don't have a real business. You have a punch of the clock job that might be highly paid, but you have no real asset. You can't sell it because you don't own it. If you decide to go to a new company, you can't take it with you. You just lost your most valuable asset. You're building your house on someone else's title. Not smart, right? So it's really mission critical that you own your database, that you have freedom to leverage and monetize your database. So never sign that away, ever. It's career suicide. You leave hundreds of thousands of dollars, perhaps millions of dollars on the table if you do that. So just saying, make sure you take that and apply it to your business, because I'm telling you what, I can't tell you how many mortgage professionals I've talked to that have missed out on hundreds of thousands of deals because they did not know that and or they didn't heed it. Don't let that be you. So when it comes to your database, I was talking about this. I was talking with this guy who signed his life away, basically his database away. So now he doesn't have control over it. He can't retrieve it. He can't even get access to the data. And he's asking if he has the freedom to do this. And the company's saying, no, you don't. You signed this waiver, da, 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 da. And they say, just to kind of, I guess, make him feel a little better and to have him feel like at least he's being placated a little bit, they said, we'll mine the gold from your database. We'll do the proactive database marketing. I guarantee you it's going to be cookie cutter crap that's boring, snoring, and is not going to work. It's not going to produce the results. It's not going to get the eyeballs. If it gets the eyeballs, it's not going to get the response. It's a waste of time, a waste of money. But again, they're doing this just to placate him. It's a delay tactic because they're saying, hey, 6 months from now, we'll do this for you. We'll revisit this. In the meantime, let us do it for you. I guarantee you it's going to be lackluster in the results. So that's one thing you really need to be cognizant of. And again, I'm not poo-pooing what they're doing. They're doing the best they can with what they have, with what they know. I'm not saying they have ill intentions. I'm just saying they're generalists. They're not marketing experts. They're generalists, which leads to another reason why chances are your company is not going to be able to support you to create a breakthrough. And that is this. They are not experts at marketing. They're experts at mortgages. They are experts at mortgages. They are not experts at marketing. They are more of generalists than they are specialists. So they know a lot about products, programs. They know a lot about how to find the home for the loan. They know a lot about compliance. They know a lot about what worked for them 10, 15, 20 years ago. They don't know the cutting edge marketing technology and mindset that allows you to own your power, to monetize your database, maximize repeat and referral business, to be able to dominate on Google with 5-star reviews, to be able to attract top producing agents like a hot knife through butter without the hell of cold calling. They do not have specialized knowledge in this stuff. And if you don't get that knowledge, if you don't invest in yourself to acquire that knowledge, you are heading to the gunfight with a butter knife. You're trying to build the foundation for a skyscraper with a gardening trowel. That ain't going to go so well. It's not about putting in more hours, friends. It's about getting more from the hours you're putting in. It's not just about activity. It's about productivity. You know it and I know it. If you want to hit your income goals for 2020, we got to get you uber effective. We got to get you potently profitable with every hour you invest and every dollar you invest. And how you do that is specialized knowledge, not generalist, but specialist. And if you are on this call or listening to this podcast episode and you're realizing, you know what? There's a lot of delusional optimism that's been creeping in. I've been relying on my marketing department. I've been relying on my sales manager and leaning on my company a lot more than I need to. I need to start to apply extreme ownership that if it is to be, it's up to me. If I want to create a breakthrough in my life and my business, I can't be holding my breath, hoping, wishing, and praying that my company shows up and delivers me to the promised land. I got to own my power. I got to grab the bull by the horns and I got to take extreme ownership for my life and my business and say, screw it, let's freaking do it. And take ownership for your own leadership development, your own personal development, your own professional development. Because if you don't take a stand for that, who will? If you don't take a stand for you getting that expertise, that sophistication, and that muscle, who will? If you don't take a stand for becoming a better version of yourself and getting the skill, the knowledge, the acumen, the expertise to be able to own your power and provide for your family at the level they deserve and at the level you're capable of, who will? And therein lies the reason why people come to us for help, because we've got specialized knowledge. We've been in the game for 16 years, and this is all we do all day, every day. We eat it for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. This is all we do, friends. And we've gotten dang good at it. We're the best on planet Earth at it. And we've got testimony upon testimony upon testimony as proof in the pudding to back that up. Don't believe what I say. Believe what my clients say. Kick-ass success stories, testimonials all day long and Sundays on our website, on our Facebook business page, Mortgage Marketing Coach on Facebook. Check it out. And so if you're right now listening to this, you're like, Dorn, I'm reading your mail, brother. I'm picking up what you're putting down. I'm feeling it. I understand. I need to get that specialized knowledge. I understand that I cannot rely on my company to help me get the marketing superpower to create my breakthrough. I've got to be intentional and purposeful about pursuing that for myself, leading by example and investing in my own leadership, my own skill, and my own sophistication. If that's you and you want to increase your income by at least $100,000 plus per year, and you're a residential 100% commission loan officer making at least 70 basis points per on your commissions per deal, and you want to take your business to the next level and you're sick and tired of spinning your wheels, banging your head against the wall, and doing it the hard way, and you're ready to learn the secret sauce on how to do it the smart way, I invite you to take advantage of a complimentary breakthrough call at mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. Again, that's mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. On that call, we're going to get together either with myself or one of my consultants. We're going to lift up the hood on your business. We're going to look at what's working, what's not working, where you're at now in your business. Where do you want to be in your business? If we can create that breakthrough, by all means, we will show you how to do it with the proven plan. If not, frankly, we will be the very first people to advise you to pass on our services. Either way, our goal for you is that you leave the call with massive value, massive clarity, and chances are we'll have some fun along the way. So if that sounds cool to you and you want to learn what it really takes to create a breakthrough in your business, shortest path to the cash without messing around doing it the hard way, and hit your income goals like an absolute beast mode champion, I invite you to book your call right here, right now, mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. So there you have it, friends. Those are the reasons why you cannot afford to rely on your company to take you to the promised land. They love you. They support you. They want the best for you. But if you want a champion, you can't afford to just reserve chump change towards yourself and your business. You got to show up like a champ and invest like a champ. And you can't afford to treat this casually. Otherwise, you'll end up being a casualty. So this is Doran Aldana, mortgagemarketingcoach.com. Book a call, mortgagemarketingcoach.com/apply. Thanks for hanging with me. I trust you got value from this conversation. Now go forth, take massive action, bring massive positive action, positive energy to that action. Chances are you're going to get massive results. Thanks for hanging with me. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.